Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'd like to take the Premier up on his offer yesterday of having a meeting with the Prime Minister to discuss healthcare funding. I believe I overheard the Leader of the NDP say he would also welcome such a meeting. I have air miles I can use. I can stay with relatives in Ottawa. We can do it on the cheap. But I've said many times in this chamber that Ottawa needs to revisit its healthcare formula. It should be based on need. And if United Front would make a difference, we'd be happy to be a part of it. However, I would like an assurance that if we are going to ask for increased funding for health, will the Premier join us in committing to spending those increased fundings on health care? Because this government's actual spending on health has been frozen for 3 years.
The Honourable First Minister.
Well, this is wonderful and momentous occasion, Madam Speaker. The Liberals have finally agreed that we have a deficit in federal funding on health care. I thank the member for his intervention. I accept his comments. And now we have unanimity on the sad reality that we have to stand up to Ottawa and get them to partner to the promised levels on funding Canada's most important priority.
The Honourable Member for St. Boniface on a supplementary question.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. According to Finance Canada, since 2016-17, health transfers have increased by $250 million, while total transfers to the province have increased by over $500 million. Yet during that time, actual health spending by the province was lower in 2017 and 2018 than it was in 2016. We all want a sustainable national public health care system. Can we get unanimous agreement in this House that if a new formula increases health care funding to Manitoba, it will actually go into health care and not be used to reduce the deficit, be put in a rainy day fund, or bail out a stadium?
The Honourable First Minister.
Well, I appreciate the intervention of the member, and I would repeat that our funding this year alone for health care is $400 million more than the NDP ever invested in health care, but the fundamental point is that we're getting better results from the investment. And Madam Speaker, that's where the Liberals fall short yet again, both federally and here. They assume that if you spend more, you care more. They forget about the results or the outcomes. Madam Speaker, the Prime Minister of Canada has said that we have a low debt to GDP ratio in Canada, but he forgets to include provincial debt. We have the largest debt of any province in the country right here in Manitoba. We face monumental challenges. There are strong storm clouds approaching. We need to get our province stronger. If the member is against rainy day funds, he should put it on the record. If he's against reducing taxes, well, he already has, Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Tyndall Park on a final supplementary.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. On average, 1 in 10 people here in Manitoba are not taking the prescribed medications due to affordability. No one should have to choose between jeopardizing their health and having shelter over their heads. In order for a national pharmacare program to work, it requires partnership between the federal and provincial governments. Madam Speaker, will this government participate in and support a national pharmacare plan?
The Honourable First Minister.
Well, Madam Speaker, a couple of points I suppose are important to make here. The record of the Liberal caucus on standing up for Manitobans is very dismal in respect of health care and other issues. The record for standing up with Ottawa and Justin Trudeau is impeccable. That being said, we're here to stand for the best interests of Manitobans, and Manitoba has a very strong pharmacare program compared to most other Canadian provinces. We want to make sure that we maintain that program. The devil will be in the details. The Liberals appear not here, at least, not willing to get into the details. They just want to support Ottawa's proposal. And Madam Speaker, we want to support what's best for Manitoba, not what's best for Ottawa.
Hear, hear.